So gout is an inflammatory arthritis caused by excess uric acid in the body. And uric acid is actually a waste material made by the breakdown of what we call our purines, which are naturally found in a lot of foods, particularly those high in protein. So gout will occur when the uric acid accumulates in the body. And that will happen in instances where our intake of uric acid is overwhelmed by the capacity to excrete it. Those cases, there's so much more uric acid in the body, and that will start accumulating, crystallizing, and then depositing in various body regions, and it particularly likes joints. Because uric acid will be seen as the body as foreign, the body's own immune system will try to get rid of it. Okay. And during these episodes, the joint that's involved can become very red, very hot, very swollen, and very typically painful. These episodes are what we call our flares. If you leave it alone, a gout flare will resolve itself within a few days. But during those episodes, when you are having an attack, the joint itself can be damaged. There can be bone erosions or where episodes where the bone is being eaten up. So gout attacks can occur whenever the uric acid level in the blood acutely changes, up or down. Okay, so in fact, like any episode where you increase the load of uric acid, for example, by intake, by too much alcohol, by too much protein the day before, having a really big meal, can actually cause a gout flare. In the same way, dehydration, infection, things like that can also cause a gout flare. Even the initiation of medications for lowering down uric acid can actually cause a gout flare, and that's important to note. So treatment of gout is actually simple. It requires two arms. One is actually treatment to lower down the uric acid. The other part of treatment actually requires treating the flare-ups or the actual pain that occurs when someone has a gout attack. And the two go together hand in hand. There are some things that can be done to help prevent gout and done in a natural way. So most of these will just involve implementing a healthy lifestyle, which includes exercise, watching what you eat, and modifying things like your smoking habits and alcohol intake. The other thing that has been studied has been the use of cherry juice, which actually helps eliminate excess uric acid in the blood.